So, how do you use VSTs on LMMS? Well, that's pretty simple. There are two main ways you can use VSTs on LMMS. The first way is using a VST as a virtual instrument, and the second way is using it as an effect. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to do both. First of all, I'm going to show you how to use VST instruments. Before we start, it would be a good idea for you to go to Edit, then Settings, then click this folder icon here and look at the VST plugins directory. This is where your VST plugins will be stored. And whenever you click, whenever you try to open a VST plugin on LMMS, LMMS is gonna look for this folder here. So make sure this is an easy folder for you to find. Okay. All right. So I'm going to add a new one here. As you can see, I have lots of instruments here, but I'm going to show you how to add a new VST plugin here. That's very simple. You click here, instrument plugins, and then look for Vestige. All right. So drag it here. Okay, so in this case, it's at the very bottom because I have lots of instruments already, but if you don't have any instruments, of course, this is gonna be the first track that's gonna show. Now I have Vestige, let's click it, and let's play. Well, I mean, of course, there isn't anything because we haven't told LMMS what exactly we want. As you can see, no VST plugin loaded. So you're gonna click this folder icon, and LMMS is going to open that folder you selected in the settings, okay? And I'm going to look for a bass VST. So yeah, this one. Normally, VST plugins are gonna be DLL files, okay? And sometimes they're gonna have like a folder, if you have samples or things like that, but you're always gonna select a DLL file, okay? So bassvst.dll. Open. Okay, so yeah, it's gonna take a little while to open. Okay, so here it is, right? So this is the bass VST. You can click this X to close it down, and then if you want to see the GUI or to see that nice interface, you can always click this. Okay, so show/hide GUI. Okay. This is how you add an instrument. And how do you add an effect? Well, you might know that there are two ways to add effects on LMMS. The first way is by clicking on FX and then add effect. The other way is to use the FX mixer. In this place, you can basically add an effect to all or to many instruments at once, right? So it's the same. So in this case, I'm going to use the FX mixer, and then I have the drums here. Let's say I wanted to add something else. I'm going to click add effect here. Remember, you can add effect in two different ways, but the process is the same for both of them. I have all the effects that come with LMMS here, as well as the ones that I added. To make them easier to find, I'm going to click type here, and I'm going to look for VST. As you can see, we're gonna find instruments like drums, you know, guitars. LMMS doesn't really know what kind of VSTs we have here. So for example, it wouldn't make a lot of sense to open a guitar because a guitar is an instrument, not really an effect. I want to open the stereo, I think it's called Stereo Swapper. Yeah, Stereo Swapper. This is an effect that's basically gonna change the left and right channels, right? I use this more for just to check how my song sounds. I don't really use it as a permanent effect, you know. This is just to give you an example. Okay, so this is how you add VSTs. But how do I modify VSTs? How do I do things with VSTs? I'm going to close this down. And yeah, I want to delete that. And this is one of my songs. It's called Sunny 99. As you can see here, I have a kick, I have a hi-hat, I have a second hi-hat, a snare, and a second snare. All of these are the same VST plugin, or the same VST instrument. This is a really nice drum plugin, has really nice sounds, and it's free, by the way. Okay, I'll probably just put a link in the description so that you can download this plugin as well. All of these are the same, basically. As you can see, every VST plugin is gonna look different, and every one of them is gonna have like their own parameters. And then you might be thinking, okay, so what if I want to automate something in the VST? So I'm going to show you that with an effect. I have this effect here on the master channel, so this is basically, these effects here basically affect the whole song. Okay, so I have an equalizer and the stereo swapper here. I don't think I need that, so I'm going to delete that. I have this effect called vinyl. So it's kind of always on when I turn it on, which is kind of weird. I really like this effect, and there's something I particularly enjoy about it. So let me check that out. See how we have this button called spin down? If I click it, we're gonna have this really, really cool effect. But the problem is, how do I automate this button? How do I make this into an automatable parameter? I don't think that's a word, but well, it is now. Well, that's pretty simple. You just have to click this range icon. And what you're gonna see is a bunch of knobs, and all of these knobs are, you're able to automate all of these knobs. And basically you just have to look for the specific control that you want. So spin down is right here. Notice that if I change this, it changes it here too. And this button, I'm able to automate this button. I'm not gonna go into lots of detail on how you automate things because I have another video on automation, so you can watch that one if you want. But yeah, I have the automation track here for the spin down effect. So basically what this automation track is telling me is that the spin down effect is going to be off for this whole part here, and then it's gonna be on for this very brief moment, and then it's going to be off again. And then I don't have to worry about it, like, for this part, because the automation, the way the automation works is that whatever the last parameter was, it's gonna stay like that. In this case, the vinyl effect is gonna be off unless I add a new automation segment here telling LMMS to turn on the effect again. Alright, so notice here, I have vinyl, right? And notice how this pin down button is gonna light up for a second. But now it's off again, right? So this is how you automate a parameter when you have a VST. So click the range icon. If you need to automate something that is in a specific instrument, then you can click this range icon. I mean, it's in a different place, but it's the same icon. As you can notice, this specific instrument doesn't have any automatable parameters, which is really, really sad. But I can add the... Let me actually do that. I'm going to add the bass again. So yeah. Okay, I'm gonna stop the song and turn off the vinyl. So yeah, as you can see, I have the bass here, right? If I wanted to automate a specific parameter, I would just click this range icon here. So as you can see, it's a lot of stuff, okay? sometimes it's kind of hard to know what exactly these are. So my tip would be just change the parameters and listen to what it does. This is the best way to know what exactly these knobs are. Okay, so I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask me. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.